two, one, two, three, four. On the road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again.
Hello, everybody, and welcome back to our channel. It's a great day today here because we've got an unusual tool, one we've never had before. It's a Stanley Bell System brace, and it's got an unusual problem we need to address. So let's get down to the shop and see what's going on.
Here's a tool I've never owned before. With all my many tools, I'm surprised. But it's a hand brace, and here's what attracted me to it. You see on here it says Bell System -B, so this was made for the Bell System, and it's a Stanley, made USA Stanley, and The Bell System, for those of you who didn't know, when it was, the phone company was all one phone company before the government broke it up into smaller companies. It was the Bell System, AT&T, Bell, and started originally American Telephone and Telegraph, but commonly known as the Bell System. And they had their own purchasing department where they bought tools for all the different divisions, all the different operations, and had their name. They were special made for them, and of course they got a good deal for buying them direct from the manufacturer. They would have them made to their specifications, and they were free to change manufacturers, but when they did have tools, they were specified, and they all said the Bell System on them. I've got a screwdriver, some screwdrivers and other items that say Bell System on it. But it's the first one of these that I own. Well, here's a few interesting facts as we get into the disassembly. The chuck itself, the jaws came out and came off the tool easily. The assembly here, the ratcheting assembly that's reversible, it's all in excellent operating condition. I could take it off, but I don't know if I will or not. It looks like I'd be able to clean and lubricate this without removing all of this. I'll have to see when I get into it. The metal itself, it's old patina. I think I explained that before. That's right, I'm into the teardown. Okay, the handle, this grip here is a one piece. It's on here. There's no way that comes off. I mean, it won't make the 90 degree turn either way. It's a straight piece. The only way I could see this tool was made was that they had a piece of straight rod. They put this on here, which is a press fit on here, and then bent the tool into shape, bent the rod into shape. I mean, there's no way to have this bent and get this assembled on here. It won't make the turns. Two turns to make there, one turn here. Absolutely won't work. So we'll have to clean it up with it on the tool. The handle here seems to be, didn't seem to be any kind of release for the handle. Nothing unscrews, it just spins. So it looks like it was probably a press fit. I might be able to get it off. I don't know if it's going to accomplish a lot. I think I can work with it just as well with it on there. I'll take a look at that when I get further down here to see how we're going to handle it. But it looks like from this point, all the cleaning and effort will be made on it assembled like this, which is nothing we haven't done before. So we'll continue on. Okay, I'm here trying to restore these Bakelite handles on this tool. You can see how everything looked before by this knob, which I haven't touched yet. The wear on it and scratches on it. Really looking rough. This is a difficult material to work with. So I tried several things. First, I took this handle and scrubbed it with Scotch Brite. Then when I got it somewhat smooth, I went ahead and started using sandpaper and worked my all the way up through 800 grit. It's nice and smooth now. And then I scrubbed it with 4/0 steel wool, the finest steel wool. But while it's smooth now, it's got no luster or shine to it, so I'm going to use plastic polish on it to see what it'll do as far as shining up this Bakelite. So that's the next step. Well, I took this handle portion and first I polished it with plastics. It cleaned it up. It gave it a little bit of a light glow, not much. So I said, what the heck? I reached in and got my good old Flitz. It works on metal, plastic, fiberglass, and I gave it a shining with Flitz. And you can see what it looks like after that. Seems to be a little better, but it's just a light shine to it. I was looking for, you know, a darker, shinier finish. I don't know if I didn't get this prepped good enough. I got it as smooth as I could with up to 800 grit sandpaper. Then I used a super fine steel wool on it. And I'm still, you know, not getting much shine to it. It's clean. I'll keep working on it to see what I can do. Okay, after using the plastics finish on here and then Flitz, I wasn't getting much as far as any kind of shine. So I got out the Mother's Carnauba wax and actually it did better than the others. It's a cleaner wax. It works great on metal and I've used it on wood with good success, although it's designed for metal. And this plastic, I don't know that it's designed for that, but I'm getting a little better glow to it. It's still a little cloudy. It's not bright and shiny like a new Bakelite would be, but I've got all the nasty scratches and imperfections sanded out here. And I guess we're going to end up with a kind of a semi-gloss black type of finish, which is, that'll have to do. It certainly looks a lot better than it did. It's not the bright shiny like the new, but we'll go on and clean the rest up and see what we've got. I spent quite a bit of time with this Stanley Bell System brace and was never completely happy with it. So I put it down for a while. It's been a couple of months. I came back to it. And I got some help from the internet, which is super. What happened is I refinished it, got it working great. The logo show up nice, Bell System. Stanley on the other side here shows up very well. Bell System here, I'm sorry. Stanley over here. But it was the Bakelite handles on it. I just couldn't get them shiny and polished like, you know, original. So I saw a video on the internet, a guy who was actually refinishing a coffee grinder, of all things, an old antique coffee grinder, which is made of Bakelite. And he redid it by polishing on the buffing wheel, which I didn't try. I sanded, you know, I went everything from Scotch Brite, sanding all the way up to 800 grit, used Flitz, used plastic polish, used Reuter Carnauba, everything I could, Carnauba wax, to try to get this to shine, and I couldn't. So I tried his system, and bingo, it did the job. Here's what this handle looks like now. Can you see the shine on here? It took that Bakelite and just really shined it up, polished it up where it was just dull and flat. You got to be really careful when you do this because that buffing wheel, and this is a type of plastic, And if you get too much pressure, use it wrong, you'll just burn it, and you've got a really bad problem on your hand. So I was really careful, took it slow, but you know, the whole tool now is polished up well. An unusual tool, being a Stanley Bell System tool. I've got a few tools in the collection, so I was glad to do that, and really wanted it to look nice. And while it's not perfect, it really, it's a heck of an improvement over the way it came in here. And the knobs on it, the handle back here, and the grip knob that you grip when you're turning. So it's a nice tool now. Like I said, first one I had in my collection, and I wanted it to be nice. And it solved a problem for me. I've had a problem with Bakelite in the past. I had one on a Stanley awl, and I actually took it and ended up sanding it down and painting it because I couldn't get it to look right. But now that I know what to do, that'll help me on the future ones, and hopefully that'll be a help to you. It's something I haven't heard before in the community. So glad I got back to it, glad I took my time and to do it right, and I appreciate you watching my video.